in the feel-good world of Christianity in the year 2010, it seems that people have forgotten about the importance of the Trinity and had rather believe that, well, everyone, let's just make each other feel good. Let's not have any disagreements. Let's not have any debates over these things anymore. Let's just all get along and believe something. That is not what our church fathers did. That is not what the people who fought to protect Christianity did, was go along to get along in a world that undermined the deity of Jesus Christ and the deity of the Holy Spirit. And they fought and preserved for us the doctrine of the Trinity, and it is just as important for Christians to defend the doctrine of the Trinity today as it was when our early church fathers defended it. If you do not understand the importance of the Trinity in defending the doctrine of the Trinity, historical Trinity that is, then I would venture to say you do not have an understanding of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I want to read to you a couple of statements. One is from Theological Digest and Outlook. It was written in January of 1993, and this particular statement came from a person by the name of Victor A. Shepherd. And here's what he says concerning the Trinity. And I quote, "If the oneness in being between Jesus Christ and God the Father is cut, then the substance and the heart of the gospel is lost. For if what Christ does is not what God does, then before God, humankind's predicament is unrelieved. Again, if God himself has not come among us in the incarnation, then God's love for us, despite all of God's good intentions, stops short of God's full identification with us as sinners. In truth, it is not final love, or at least it is woefully deceitful and defective love, and the redemptive activity of God is finally ineffectual." End quote. Let me read you something else that came out of Christian Reader, October the 8th of 2009, in an article in there where this man by the name of Dr. Joseph Moorcraft is getting ready to write a book. A person quotes something out of this book he's getting ready to write. It's dealing with the practical application of the doctrine of the Trinity. And it's in a forthcoming article he's writing on authentic Christianity. Let me read you what Dr. Moorcraft had to say. And I quote, "If there were no Trinity, there would be no incarnation, no objective redemption, and therefore no salvation. For there would be no one capable of acting as mediator between God and man. If we misunderstand the Trinity, we will misunderstand the cross of Calvary. The doctrine of the Trinity and the doctrine of salvation stand and fall together. The intimacy between the doctrines of the Trinity and salvation is such that no non-Trinitarian scheme of things can be adequately found for the expression of the Christian salvation," end quote. I totally agree with both of those statements. Without the proper understanding of the Trinity, we will never understand what God was doing at Calvary. Today, through such cults as Jehovah's Witnesses, Mormons, and the Seventh-day Adventists, and others, the Trinity of historical Christianity has come under attack. If you, as a Christian, do not see the need to defend the historical doctrine of the Trinity, then I will submit to you that you are woefully lacking in an understanding of what the gospel of Jesus Christ is about. Let me again read you this statement by Dr. Moorhead. To me, it goes to the heart of what we should be doing in defending the doctrine of the Trinity. I quote again, "If there is no Trinity, there would be no incarnation, no objective redemption, and therefore no salvation. For there would be no one capable of acting as mediator between God and man. If we misunderstand the Trinity, we will misunderstand the cross of Calvary. the doctrine of the Trinity and the doctrine of salvation stand or fall together. The intimacy between the doctrine of the Trinity and salvation is such that no non-Trinitarian scheme of things can be adequately found for the expression of Christian salvation, end quote. That means to me that within these cults like Seventh-day Adventist, Jehovah's Witnesses, and Mormons, they don't understand what the gospel of Jesus Christ is about without an understanding of the Trinity. And regardless of how they try to deceive people with their doctrine of the Trinity, it is not the historical doctrine of Christianity. God was in Christ, reconciling the world to himself. And if we do not understand the Trinity, we will never have an understanding of the cross of Calvary. And we will never have an understanding of what God was doing there at Calvary. Agree or disagree, but the doctrine of the Trinity must be defended against such cults. Until next time, this has been Golly saying, God bless.